Hello, hello, hello everyone, and welcome for today's video. We are back home and this 3-week vacation in the US was just mind-blowing. It was so great, we had so much fun. And as you have seen already, we have uploaded the first videos about our trip, the travel vlogs. And in case you did not see them and wonder what we did in the US and what you've seen, which cities we have discovered or explored, more to say, please head over to them. They are available a couple videos back, and yeah, let us know what you think about it. But as I'm back now today, having my microphone back in my hands, I can make the proper voiceover for the next videos. This one is a project that I already had filmed before the vacation, so I hope I can remember everything correctly. I wanted to try a paint kiss pour. I think I did this one time before, I don't really remember, but I wanted to give this another shot, or the first shot, I don't know. As I'm not that familiar with this kind of technique, I decided to use a pour that I did before, which dried, which I did not really like because it lacked some contrast, and pour over this one. The pour that I did before I did not make a video about because I just didn't like it so much. It was an attempt with a brownish color palette, so a dark brown, a cream and a white, but overall it lacked contrast, so I didn't really fell to it. So I let it dry, it was a canvas board, so it's something you can really use over and over again to test out new things, to over pour if it didn't work out, and if you once get a result that you like, you can keep it. And on top of this, they are so thin that you can store them easily. Of course, yes, they bend or tend to bend over time, but when you store them lying, separated with a sheet of baking paper or something, you can stack them up. And their own weight is going to make them even, and they're pretty good to go. But make sure to have some baking paper or something like that in between, otherwise all of them will glue together into one giant stack of unseparable canvas boards. So make that sure. But other than that, I mixed up my paints as I usually do, so the same mixture as I always use. And one is white, one is Phthalo Blue, and one is gold. To make this paint kiss thingy work, as you've seen already, I mixed two cups. One is just the white and the blue, and one is just white and the gold. And I'm pouring the paints at the same time so that they actually meet when they come out of the cup, you know? So I just want to see how this design in the end is going to differ from the ones that I had before, using my 3-tool cup, 5-tool cup, or having everything just put into one cup like a regular ring pour. Just to see what this is going to create. Once the paint was out, as usual, there was the stretching and the hoping for the best result. I was not so sure about the direction the contrast is going to go for this pour as well, because I really did use a lot of white. I most of times love it more when it's a bit darker with some lighter highlights and the gold in between of them, kind of. So it was pretty much white, and it muted down the Phthalo Blue quite a bit, and the gold also had a hard time coming through, but overall I really liked the design and what I received or achieved in the final look when it was dry. You will again see it at the very end. As I, as usual, had some paint left over left, I decided to use 3 small canvases that I also poured before, which I also did not like, and use the rest amount of paint for them, just to see if this works out, and if so, perhaps it's kind of a set piece, so a larger one and 3 smaller ones. Who knows, we will see. This, by the way, is something that I always do, so whenever I do have a pour which kind of failed and did not really like so much, I do not waste any of the canvases, nor do I waste any of the paint. So if I have too much drip of paint, as you've seen me done before, I'm going to put this into my drip off jar and use it for background color for other pours, or when I go on pouring with the same colors that I had, I'm using the drip off paint as I did here in these pieces and use them as the background color just to have this used up. And pour as much as I can just to be as little wasty as possible. And also canvases, as long as you pour is a flat one, so there are no bumps, lumps and whatsoever in there, and you have not created any texture over time, I keep re-pouring over and over until I get a result that I really like for myself, or that I would feel good about putting out for sale. Once I have a pour that I do not like and do have texture on my canvas or my board, whatever I'm working on, I still do not waste it. I just keep it and use it for something resin based. So if I decide to make a geode or something on this, I tend to add some texture anyways, so why waste a fully functional canvas, although it has some lumps and bumps on there. So just keep it stored until I can use it for something other. So just in case this did not cross your mind before, perhaps you want to start doing this as well to save on art supplies. Yeah, and as you can see, this was pretty much everything that I did. Yes, and now it was again some ring pour-ish like artwork. But I hope you still like it. Let me know in the comments what you think about it, if you like it as a set piece, so like all four together, or if you like just one or two of them, what do you think about the large one and the final design that I got there. I really pretty much like all of them, so cannot wait to hear what you think. If you do have a suggestion for me, what you like me pour for the next project, perhaps another technique, something that you like me want to try, but please no Dutch pours, I'm really, really not that good at them. So yeah, I'm back home, I cannot wait to start the next projects. I still have a couple that I need to voice over from before my vacation, but new stuff is about to come. And of course, as usual, I cannot wait to read your comments, what you want me to test out, or to try, or to create in the future. Just let me know. For those who followed my vacation vlogs already and left so many sweet comments, thank you so much. We really, really were happy reading all of them. It was just a joy connecting with you guys during our vacation, and we had so much fun there, and you just brightened up our day with every comment that you've sent. So thank you so, so much. If this was the first video that you've seen of mine, please make sure to give me a thumbs up if you liked the video, subscribe if you haven't done so far, share the video with everyone that you know. My social media links are down below in the video description in case you want to stay in touch. And you can also find all the materials that I've used for this project down below. And something that I would like to announce for everyone who's watching this video, very near in the future I'm going to voice over a couple of videos that I've already uploaded on my channel in the English version, and will re-voice it for the German language version, so my mother language actually. Just because of the reason that I had a couple of requests voicing some more videos in German, and therefore I picked a couple of them that I think might help out a couple people and will just re-voice them in German. This will be across all of my art techniques that I'm doing. So it will be charcoal, it will be color pencil, it will be acrylic pouring, it will be oil painting, and the resin artwork as well. So I know that most of you are here because of my acrylic pouring and abstract artwork, but for those who are also into my realism, there is a playlist in my playlist where you can find all my realism works and tutorials to probably give color pencil a try, or your oil paints that you have been scared of all so long you might want to use after this one as well. So of course I would feel honored if you have a look at those videos as well, and also if you have a look at the coming videos. So thank you for your time, thank you for watching, and other than that, I hope to see you in my next video. Have a great day. Bye bye.